For the people who live on the low ground between England and Wales, it's been a long wet winter. Floodwater has rendered useless the kilns at the heart of Gary Jones' ceramics business.
Gavin physically got the strength to lift them up out of the flood, so they've copped it.
Gary bears the scars on his arms from his efforts to protect his village from the flood.
It's blocked with a stubble that we pulled out weeks and weeks ago, and there is a 3-foot drop the other side.
It was totally full of stubble.
He and his neighbours think that hedgerows blocked up with stubble from surrounding fields stopped the floodwater from escaping harmlessly onto the floodplain. They spent the last 2 days clearing it out again.
Now, you're in touch with the authorities about this, aren't you? The Environment Agency, the local council.
They are aware, but it's a hot potato and they keep passing it from one to the other. And in the meantime, while they're doing all this passing about, coming to a decision, we're flooding. This is the third time in 4 months.
Millions of pounds have been spent on flood defences in this area. And for the Environment Agency, for the most part, they're working.
In the Severn and Wye catchment, a flood of this magnitude 20 years ago, we would see 7,000 to 10,000 properties that would have been flooded. But what we're seeing is about 1,000 properties being flooded. So actually those flood risk management schemes have really made a massive difference.
In the face of ever more frequent flooding events, authorities will have to become more adept in their immediate response. But they'll also have to make the right calls when it comes to longer term development and meeting the demand for more housing.
On this site outside Ledbury, a town which remains under flood alert tonight, a developer wants to build more than 600 new homes. It's appealing the local council's decision to reject the planning application.
The Environment Agency says that its flood modelling can indicate to the developer where it's safe to build. However, they've also admitted that their flood models don't take into account the level of runoff that we have from large-scale farming operations.
Predictions about where flood defences might be most needed in years to come can never be absolutely precise. Along the rivers and around the floodplains, making sure every home is protected will be impossible. Geraint Vincent, News at 10, Herefordshire.